In today's results-oriented world, it has become too easy to look at only wins and losses. Success is important. But so too are the experiences enjoyed and the education gained along the way. The 2007 St. Ignatius Wildcats embarked on the journey that is a football season. A campaign of hope and disappointment, pain and jubilation. This is their story and the lessons learned in the process. There were many stories to the 2007 season, but the spotlight shone brightest on the Wildcats' defense. This was a group who relished the chance to dictate a game.
We can attack from anywhere. Snap the ball, we could overload blitz, change coverages right in it as the play's running.
It's a lot of fun because there's guys coming from every which direction on almost every play, and offense usually doesn't know what's going on.
Anybody could blitz, the cornerbacks, the safeties, the linebackers, and so it was a fun defense to run. I think our coaches had a fun time working with it.
The attacking Wildcats shut out four opponents during the regular season. In the blanking of Massillon, the Tigers didn't cross midfield until the game's final play. Ignatius allowed less than 12 points per game, and some of those points came from the opposition's defense or special teams. They were successful because they knew the defense would work only if they were all in it together.
Definitely the idea of how a team defense can work with the system that we have was evident to the kids. It was interesting because a kid will make a big play, but everybody else contributed to that big play.
Everybody pretty much like work in tandems. Usually if one part of one group isn't working, then the whole team isn't working.
That was important, and kids really caught on to that idea. And certainly somebody made the tackle, but it was probably because the other 10 guys contributed strongly.
Individually, the Cats' D was paced by senior co-captain and All-Ohio linebacker Steve Vigak. The district defensive player of the year averaged 10 tackles a game and had 9 sacks. Fellow captains Emmett Leiden and Chase Steins also excelled. Leiden was second-team All-State with over 100 tackles, while Steins had 70 stops and recovered 3 fumbles. Senior Brian Conway played both linebacker and defensive end. He had 7 sacks among his tackles. Up front, classmates Kevin Midgley, an honorable mention all-district choice, and Chuck Wepler combined for more than 80 tackles and 10 sacks. While junior Ryan Carr was a force in the middle. Sophomore Scott McVay was explosive at outside linebacker. In the secondary, senior Matt Shirtlift garnered first-team All-Ohio honors, leading the team with 3 interceptions. 2 of those returned for scores. His brother Nick manned the other cornerback spot, with Nate Rossi and Sean Fitzgerald contributing. Juniors Dan Fox and Pat Hinkle had fine years in their first as starters. The duo had almost 140 tackles between them, with 3 interceptions, 2 returned for touchdowns. All for one and one for all. The Ignatius defense had a banner year. No game showed the D better than the confrontation with the eventual Ohio State champion, Cincinnati St. Xavier.
Xavier's a very good football team, and all week I think people were even saying, oh, well, hopefully you'll play a good game against them.
We knew that we were playing the best, and that we knew that we had to be at our top of our game. And about, I think it was like midway through second quarter, we thought, hey, we can beat these guys.
Nationally ranked in the top 5 all year, the St. X Bombers would finish the season unbeaten. A perfect 15-0. But at no time was that mark threatened more than on this sunny afternoon at Byers Field.
In the second half, Coach Corrigan just said, come out and be victorious. No matter what the score says, no matter if they hold us to 0 points, they are not going to score on us, and our defense is going to take over, and we are going to be victorious.
St. X averaged more than 35 points a game in the regular season, but the Wildcats held them to a 7-all standoff through 4 quarters. Darius Ashley gained 145 yards a game for St. X and ran for 271 in the state title game with Menor. The Cats made certain, however, each and every yard was hard fought on this day. The Bombers' high-potent offense was held to half its usual total output of nearly 400 yards, and that included 3 overtime periods. It was a game of magnificent effort and an outcome oh so close.
We certainly played a high-level playoff football game right there on that Saturday afternoon. That was the equivalent of whatever you want to call it, a regional final, maybe even a state final if things worked out right. It was going to come down to somebody who was going to make a play, and they made the one that we didn't.
A first-time matchup with LaSalle High School turned into a special Friday night in Cincinnati for the Wildcats. With the leading rusher in the Cincinnati area, running back Kendall Owens, and two-way performer Devere Posey, an Ohio State recruit, the Lancers would provide a formidable challenge. The Wildcats struck quickly. A 3-and-out. And a bad punt snap put Ignatius on the board in the game's opening minute. With good field position following the free kick, Andrew Holland hit Connor Ryan for 20. Holland's quarterback draw put the ball inside the 15. And then Andrew and Connor connected again. It was 9-0 Ignatius. LaSalle would get a touchdown from Posey, but overall the defense made life miserable for the Lancer offense, especially quarterback Brendan Jones. Late in the second quarter, Andrew Holland injures his right shoulder on a draw play. What would the rest of the Wildcats do to support his replacement, sophomore Mark Myers?
Well, we needed to have confidence in Mark, and that was the biggest thing because, you know, Andrew, we had so much confidence in him, great player. He went down and everyone was like, uh-oh, you know, what are we going
to
do?
Their job was to make sure that it wasn't going to be his problem the rest of the game, that they were going to handle this, and to keep smiling, keep laughing. This is fun.
Myers would toss a completion on his first play from scrimmage. That led to a Nick Yako 43-yard field goal and a 12-7 halftime lead. The relentless pressure by the Cats D handcuffed LaSalle at every turn. When Pat Hinkle picked off a Jones pass and returned it for a touchdown, the Wildcats' advantage grew to 19-7. LaSalle's offense was completely shut down, but a Posey interception return cut the lead to 5, and with just over 2 minutes left, LaSalle took its first lead on a long Kendall Owens punt return. Now, could a sophomore quarterback rally his team with one final drive?
Here's a sophomore that made that trip all the way down there thinking he was going to have a clipboard on his side writing plays down, and suddenly now you're in the big ball game, in the thick of a real dramatic ball game. And he handled it well, and his teammates around him handled it well, too.
Two quick completions to Connor Ryan produced a first down.
It was great to watch him drive the ball down the field at the end of the game. I actually looked at Brian Conway and we're like, dude, we can't do anything. You know, we can't do anything. We're just sitting here watching.
A slant to Pat Ryan set up a little bit of luck the Wildcats' way.
Myers scrambling, throws in there, no, caught! What a catch!
I was on the other side of the field, and I saw their star player, Posey, tip it up, and I was thinking, you know, it's intercepted. And then to see Connor come down with it on the ground was just ridiculous.
This swing pass to Mike Anner gobbled up more yards, and then a great play call.
Mark Myers, the backup, doing a nice job on this drive. He's going to keep it. He's going to pick up the first down and more. Myers inside the 10-yard line, finally brought down.
In the closing second, senior Nick Yako pierced the night with the game-winning kick in a most memorable victory. The LaSalle effort was typical of an offense that found contributions from multiple sources. Senior co-captain Steve Bigak saw some action both ways. He joined fellow senior line mates Tim Matty, Jeff Berlin, and Frank Vitale up front. Center Brian Connolly led a junior group that included Frank Whitaker and Jared Kedzior. The offense averaged about 33 points a game with 3,000 yards of total offense. Junior quarterback Andrew Holland, an honorable mention all-district choice, contributed nearly 1,100 yards and accounted for 17 touchdowns in the 8 games he played before his injury against LaSalle. Sophomore quarterback Mark Myers added more than 450 yards passing and running, and he scored 3 times. 12 different receivers caught passes, headed up by juniors Connor Ryan and Joe Paris, both honorable mention all-district. The duo combined for 60 catches and 12 touchdowns. Seniors Pat Ryan and tight end Kyle Kramer were the other starters. They averaged more than 14 yards per catch. The kicking game was solid. Senior Nick Yako was second team All-Ohio, booming long-range field goals and kickoffs into the end zone. Senior Ryan Hansen averaged 37 yards a punt. The running game was young overall, but dangerous. Junior Mike Anner averaged more than 5 yards a carry and scored 5 times. Classmate Frank DeSico scored 4 touchdowns and gained better than 4.5 yards whenever he touched the ball. Senior co-captain Emmett Lydon finished off many drives down close. 9 different backs toted the leather, with Mike Bendikaitis, Sam LaGuardia, and Robert McAvoy adding blocking duties at fullback as well. With most of this group returning, the prospects for 2008 look bright. Perhaps too much is made of it, but there is little doubt that the annual battle with St. Edward's is one of the focal points of any season.
Everyone looks at their season based off the St. Ed's game. You know, a lot of alumni look back and say, oh, well, who won? Ignatius, Ed's. Well, it may not be the goal of our season to beat St. Ed's. I mean, the goal of our season is to win a state championship. But there's a little extra with that win.
It's so important to the students. It's so important to alumni. It's so important that people, that the kids have gone to school with the Ed's kids in grade school. And it's always a hard-fought game. I think kids always anticipate that it's going to be a close game no matter what the records are, because the emotions are very high.
Not a lot of St. Ignatius teams have gone through like their 3 years or 2 years on varsity and not beaten St. Ed's, and we didn't want to be that team.
St. Ed's would grab an early edge on a fake field goal. But Matt Shurtleff pushed the momentum back the Wildcats' way. This Kevin Midgley stop put the Eagles into a third and long situation. And it was Matt Shurtleff again, dazzling the full house at Lakewood with this interception return. Making his second varsity start, sophomore quarterback Mark Myers was settling in, even with some St. Edward's extracurriculars. Meanwhile, the Cats on defense were thwarting the Eagles' sophomore quarterback Alex Levisky. Late in the second, Myers finds Joe Paris deep in the red zone. From there, Emmett Lydon does the rest. The second half on offense featured running back Mike Anner and some terrific blocking up front. Mr. Touchdown Emmett Lydon closed out this drive in a 19-7 advantage. The aggressive approach on defense didn't change. This was a fourth down stop in the third quarter. A blown call on what should have been a Chase Steins interception allowed the Eagles to close to within 5. But plays like this 62-yard punt by senior Ryan Hansen kept any upset thoughts by the Eagles at bay. The defense pressured. The offense pounded. And the Eagles were shut down. On a rainy night in October, ownership of the Madhouse on Madison once again belonged to the Wildcats. The Wildcats' 20th straight trip to the playoffs, an ongoing state record, brought another matchup with powerful Glenville. The big and fast Tarblooders would have the ball for 21 of the game's first 25 plays. But it was Ignatius that struck first on this Dan Fox interception. The extra point was unsuccessful and Glenville would take a 7-6 lead. But the offense would move smartly down the field on its next possession. Only to have a tip pass in the red zone turn into another Glenville score. Undaunted, the offense started anew. A 28-yard Mark Myers to Connor Ryan completion was a big third down pickup. The pair hooked up for another first down, setting up Mike Anders' touchdown run with 40 seconds left in the first half. Early in the third, a 60-yard run sent Glenville to the goal line. But it took four tries for the Tarblooders to break the 13 all-time. Matt Shurtleff took the ensuing kickoff nearly to midfield. Joe Parris grabbed a third down completion. The line cracked the Glenville front and Mike Anner raced for 21 more. Mark Myers then found Connor Ryan in the end zone and things were tied up again. Steve Bigank and the Wildcat D were into the attack mode now. A daring Frank DeSico punt return. Set up Nick Yako's 42-yard field goal and Ignatius was up by three. The D was magnificent. A three and out set up another scoring opportunity, but a fake field goal try misfired. Glenville would have just 47 net yards of offense in the second half, even with that early 60-yard run. But a ball with pointy ends can take funny bounces. And in heartbreaking fashion, the Wildcats' title hopes faded away.
I always look at the football program here at St. Ignatius as definitely an educational experience. For me, it's an important part of education. We, as you look at our schedule this year, it was a more challenging schedule than people really realized. It was a learning experience for the kids that the challenges are every week, and you can talk about, hey, how great last week's ball game is, but there comes a point where that shuts off, and that's a reality in this world. It's what's coming up. What's your next challenge? And I think our kids had a very good perspective on that and learned a lot about that.
The 2007 season exemplified those challenges. The only regular season losses came against the two teams in the state championship game. And as for the playoffs, well,
play the game with a ball that has ends. And Coach Kyle said it before, sometimes it just doesn't bounce your way. I think that's the way life is. Sometimes the ball just doesn't bounce your way. It's how you bounce back from that really matters. You know, that's what the character of a person really is. When something doesn't go your way, and what you do to come back from that.
Part of that experience gained, those lessons learned, came from being a Wildcat. having the opportunity to play for the man who has guided the program for the past 25 years.
I was one of those kids that wore the Ignatius number one jersey when I was a little kid, and I slapped all the players' hands when they were going back to the locker room. It means a lot to me to have played in this program for Coach Kyle, for such a great coaching staff.
It's a remarkable experience that I'll, you know, take with me my entire life. I don't think anything could ever be like it. He just really gets you and to play for him, and just inspirational, gets you to play beyond your ability.
The passion still burns for the St. Ignatius football program. The challenges, the work, and the glory will go on.
Even though we didn't quite reach our goal, you know, I take all the memories and everything, it's so worth it.
Our goal always will be to play, to try to get it, play the state championship game. We're trying to get there, and we're going to get there again, and that's the way we plan it and the way we work at it, and I couldn't tell these kids anything different.
Building. Thank you and good night.